Last time we stopped our discussion on duty drawback, and we stopped at the submitting additional information requirement. So once you file for the drawback, once you make the drawback claim, you may find yourself in a situation where you need to submit additional stuff. So some of additional stuff is required by customs. Customs comes back to you and says, hey, I need more documents, I need more information to make to approve your claim. Sometimes you may want to come forward and you may want to come in and say, listen, customs, some additional stuff has come up as a part of this application packet. I would like to submit this to your attention. So if customs comes to you and asks for additional information, this is called claim perfection. And if the if you are going to come in to customs on your own, it's going to be called claim amendment. The difference between those two is that you are limited to the by statute of limitations as to whether or not you can amend your claim. However, to perfect the claim, meaning that customs comes back to you and asks, the statute of limitation is not so strict on that one, because under the rules, under the old rules, let me see, let's go to our Code of Federal Regulations. So the time limitation. Let's see. Okay, so it's 190. So we are in 191.51, which has a statute of limitation. So the old rule, time of filing a complete drawback claim with all documents shall be filed within 3 years after the date of exportation and destruction. So once you export or destroy it, you have 3 years to do that. And if it's beyond the 3 years, if it deals with perfection, in other words, customs comes to you, additional documents may be submitted. If it's amendment, it may not be. I mean, if you are doing it on your own initiative, you are bound by that statute of limitations, as unlike with a claim perfection. So so this 3 year rule, of course, is while it's still in the books, it has been amended by the Trade Facilitation and Trade Enforcement Act. So now we have a different statute of limitations, which, let's see, I believe this would be R, right? So we're talking about 19 U.S.C. 1313 R. The regulations will be made pursuant to that statute. So this is statutory stuff. This is comes directly from Congress, not from customs. A drawback entry shall be filed no later than 5 years from the date of importation, right? So instead of 3 years from the date of exportation or destruction, now you have 5 years from the date of importation to file a drawback entry. So the kickoff, the clock begins to tick on a different time. It used to be date of exportation and destruction. Now it's date of importation. No, remember, don't confuse date of importation with date of entry. Those are two different things. It's date of importation. And instead of 3 years, it's 5 years. So, but you have to be flexible and you have to be comfortable with both, because customs may, whenever customs makes that adoption, they may implement this change, and when they implement this change, you have to be flexible with both, because by the time you sit on the exam, that rule may come into effect and it may be something which may come up on the exam. If it doesn't, great, you're flexible with both, old 3-year rule and new 5-year rule. All right, let's go to outline. All right, so claim perfection is pretty much the submission of additional documentation to customs, and if customs comes to you, you have 30-day window to respond. Of course, you may extend that, but you have to provide good reasons, such as the information is stored off-site, and you have logistical difficulties, so you need more time, or your file got corrupted and you have IT engineers working on restoring the file, if you have an electronic storage, something which shows that you are working on getting the stuff. So notice that the regulation does not provide, does not make explicit whether it's calendar day or the working day. So whenever there is no explicit statement, it usually means the calendar day, which is more strict from the importer vantage point, because it doesn't break, it takes into account the holidays and the weekends. Alright, so what type of additional stuff can customs ask a drawback claimant? Well, evidence of export, the fact that it was exported, evidence of import, affirmation from the exporter, commercial documents on the import side, commercial documents on the export side, so official documents, shipping documents, commercial documents, certificate of delivery, CBP form 7552. So those are the type of documents that customs can come back and ask you as a part of the application. And here I make a little note that I described, which because of the trade enforcement and trade facilitation and trade enforcement act of 2015 came into effect, you now have 3-year rule and 5-year rule to be mindful of at the same time. All right, that's perfection. Amendment of the claim, right, is when customs does not come to you and make this as a requirement, you kind of do it on your own because you think this information will be helpful in more efficient or more appropriate or more accurate processing of your duty drawback claim. So again, it is done on the filers, on the claimant initiative, to provide additional information or change the information that you have already given. And unlike the perfection of the claim, you are limited to 3 years after the date of exportation and destruction under the old 3-year rule, or 5-year rule from the date of entry, date of importation under the Trade Facilitation and Trade Enforcement Act rule. All right, so here comes one way as how customs examiners test you on that statute of limitations as far as claim perfection and claim amendment is concerned. What is the time period allowed to amend unliquidated drawback claim? As we shall see, we will have the unliquidated come in the scene, but for now let's focus on the time period. So it's 3 years after the date of exportation and destruction. It's the 3-year rule that I was talking about previously, of the articles that are subject to the original drawback claim. So again, we're talking about claim amendment, right? We're not talking about perfection. If it was perfection, that would be a different story. It's a claim amendment. So buzzword here is amendment, all right? Another buzzword is unliquidated, because if it's liquidated, that's it. You can't do it. It's just like with the regular entry, drawback entries tend to go through their liquidation cycles, and because they tend to go through their liquidation cycles, they must liquidation is final computation of duties and fees. So if that final state act has taken place, then there is really no recourse outside of other than to file a protest or go to Court of International Trade. All right, so 10 years after the date of exportation, 90 days unlimited, none are not correct because we're dealing with 3 years after the date of exportation of destruction. Under the old system, under the new system, it's 5 years from the date of importation. All right, moving on. So amending the claim or supplemental filings. Claim amendment is also sometimes called, AKA, also known as supplemental filing. All right, so that supplemental filing is also on the books. There is another concept. So this is one concept. This is another concept. There is also another concept called restructuring. We'll talk about restructuring in a bit. Restructuring. All right, but just keep in mind, this concept is also out there. All right, so amending the claim, we're talking about when a claimant does it on its own will, is not available for drawbacks, for drawback entries that are liquidated. You have to go with the protest for that one. So the protest procedure is a separate chapter, is a separate discussion. Let me just briefly mention that under the Code of Federal Regulations, the protest procedure is covered under 174. Part 174, protests. Right now we are dealing in part 191, drawback. All right, so going back to our outline, let's take a look at the next question. So a broker files a drawback claim on behalf of his client on February 1999. All right, so you have February 1st, 1999. The exports on the claim range from April 1st, 1998 and to January 1st, 1999. So the earliest export on the claim was 4/1/1998. All right. And that's the earliest one. In April 2000, the client asked the broker to amend the claim. The drawback entries are covered by the claim have not yet been liquidated. May the broker file the amended claim? So we're talking about the claim amendment. And because we're talking about the claim amendment, we know that under the old rule, it's 3 years from the date of exportation and destruction. The earliest entry that was exported or destroyed, right? Rather exported, not destroyed, was 4/1/1997. So 3 year period under the old rule would be 4/1/2001, right? That would be the time. But the client asked the broker in April 2000, way before the April 2001 deadline. So the answer to the question under the old rule is yes, they can do that. Under the new rule, they can do that because it would be 5 years from the, 5 years from the date of entry. We do not know when the entry was made. So under the new rule, we do not have enough information to answer this question. But under the old rule, we have 3 years. So let's look at the answer choices to see which ones are wrong and which one is correct. So first one is no, because filed drawback claims cannot be amended. We know that's not true. Under 191.51, they can be amended. Yes, because unliquidated drawback claims can be amended at any time. Just a second, let me just drive this point home. I said 191.51. Whenever we talk about the relevant regulation, it's usually cited here. It's 191.52. I'm sorry. And 191.52, if you go to the Code of Federal Regulations, you will see that 191.52 here claim rejection, claim perfection, and claim amendment. And the next one that I did briefly mention is claim restructuring is under 199.53. So keep in mind those regulatory sections, because as we shall see briefly, customs has a tendency also to ask on to test your knowledge on where those sections lie. So going back to our amendment. So we're talking about amendment. We know it's 3 years. Just a second, I think. We skipped the question. So going back to this, we know that the 4/1/2001 is a deadline under the 3 year rule. And we know that it's not, the deadline has not yet passed. So the answer to the question is, may the broker file amend the claim? Yes, they may. So you can take out answer C and answer A, because no is not appropriate. Yes, however, the devil lies in details, because you need to find out which one is appropriate, which rationale, which reasoning is appropriate. So here you have to look at one. Unliquidated drawback claims can be amended any time up to the date of liquidation on drawback entries. No. Liquidation of the entry and the three-year rule, they are not they may be somewhat parallel to each other, but the liquidation cycle is an independent cycle. So the liquidation cycle, which is final computation of duties and fees, this is not by all means. There is no, and we have a whole discussion, whole chapter on liquidation itself. They follow its own rules. They follow its own logic. So unliquidated drawback claims can be amended any time up to the date of liquidation of the drawback entries. No, the answer is no, because liquidation can last well beyond the three-year period after the date of export or destruction. So that timeline over here is not necessarily means liquidation. Liquidation can go in and say, let's say, can liquidate on 4/1/02. Right, 2002. So that is a possibility. So this is not necessarily the outcome. It may be the outcome, but it is not necessarily true. Let's take a look at D. Another answer choice: yes, because unliquidated drawback claims may be amended within 3 years, neither explicitly citing the three-year rule, after the date of exportation and destruction of the articles, which are subject to the original drawback. So. Yes, right on point. Mentions the three-year rule and something that we are looking for as a response to the question. E, well, we know it's okay. So no is not correct answer. Unliquidated drawback claims must be protested. No, unliquidated drawback claims protest is an option. They do not have to be protested. So that's not very responsive to the question in the first place.